Now that we've created an LFO for our synth, the next step is to sync that LFO to the tempo. In this video, we'll go over how to get the LFO synced up with your host tempo, so that you can choose its speed based on note values instead of using a slider. Syncing the LFO to the tempo is a common feature found in a synth, and it's not too complicated to set up once you understand what needs to be done to get it working. The first thing we need to do is select the oscillator inside the LFO. The oscillator will generate a wave, with the pitch being determined by the voltage passed into its pitch plug. Currently, it will respond at 1 volt per octave, meaning for every volt you pass in, the pitch will rise by 1 octave. This won't work for what we're trying to do. What we want is for the oscillator to respond in kilohertz. In other words, 1 volt passed into the oscillator is equal to 1 kilohertz, or 1000 hertz. We can change the way the oscillator responds by setting frequency scale to 1 volt/kilohertz. Now, since we're going to be syncing this LFO with the tempo, we're not going to need this rate slider anymore. I'm not going to delete it though. I'll just disconnect the patch cord between it and the oscillator's pitch plug. Let me make a little more room inside the LFO container. Okay, now let's add another container inside of the LFO's container. I'll name this new container Tempo Sync. Go ahead and open the Tempo Sync container. Since there's no need for any inputs to the Tempo Sync module, I'll move the I/O mod to the right side of the container. To sync the LFO with the host project tempo, we need a way to reference the tempo of the project. We can do this with the BPM Tempo module, located under Special. I'll add the BPM Tempo module to the Tempo Sync container. The BPM Tempo module provides the beats per minute in volts, and the default value is 120 beats per minute, which means it will currently send 120 volts out. If we open this plugin inside of a DAW, it would automatically grab the tempo and begin sending the appropriate amount of voltage. We need to convert this BPM value to a frequency, measured in kilohertz. If we were to divide the BPM by 60, we could get the number of beats per second. So, I'll add a divide module from under the math category. For input 1, I'll send in the value we're getting from the BPM tempo module. Now, beats per second is equal to the frequency we're looking for, only it's in hertz instead of kilohertz. So if we divide by 60 to get the frequency in hertz, we can divide by 60,000 to get the frequency in kilohertz. We can do this by adding a fixed value module, which you can find under the controls category. Connect the spare value plug to the input 2 plug on the divide module. If you have the spare value module selected when you connect its plug, it doesn't update the properties over here. So, select another module, and then reselect the spare values module, and we can update the value in the properties area. I'll set the name and value to 60,000. At this point, we can hook the output of the divide module up to the LFO's pitch plug, and the modulation will be synced to the length of 1 bar, or 4 beats. To show you that, I'll connect the output of the divide module to the I/O mod, and then connect the output on the tempo sync module to the LFO's pitch plug. Also, I'll turn the LFO's depth up a bit so that we can hear the result a little better. If I play a note, the LFO is synced to the tempo, completing one cycle over the course of 1 bar. This is fine, but if we could only sync to a period of 1 bar, that would be pretty limiting. I'd like to be able to sync the LFO's cycle to 1 bar, or 1 whole note, as well as to a half note, a quarter note, eighth note, and a 16th note. To do this, we'll multiply 60,000 to change its value to what we need. Remember, dividing the BPM by 60,000 gives us the frequency of 1 bar. So if we wanted a half bar, we could multiply the BPM by half of 60,000. We could get a quarter bar by dividing by 1/4 of 60,000. First, let's add a multiply module to the tempo sync module. hook up the plug from 60,000 to input 1 on the multiply module, and do this without disconnecting the original patch cord. If you disconnect a fixed value plug, the value is lost, and you'll have to re-enter its name and value when you reconnect it. So connect it to the multiply module first, and then delete the patch cord between 60,000 and the divide module. Next, we need to be able to choose what value to multiply 60,000 by to get to the corresponding frequency we want. To do that, we're going to use a switch. Under Flow Control, select Switch, Many to One. This will let us take multiple inputs and switch them between a single output. Go ahead and hook the output of the switch up to input 2 on the multiply module. Then, we need to pass in some values into the switch. So I'll add another fixed values module. And I'll connect the spare value plug to the spare input plug on the switch 5 times altogether. First, let's rename the plugs on the fixed inputs module to represent the note duration. So first will be 1, then 1/2, 1/4, 1/8, and 1/16. Let's do the same thing with the names of the plugs on the switch as well. 1, 1/2, 1/4, 1/8, and 1/16. Okay, now we need to set the values for each of these options. To get a 1-bar cycle, we need to divide by a value of 60,000, so we'll multiply 60,000 by 1. For each successive option, we just need to cut this value in half. So to get a half-note cycle, we need to multiply 60,000 by 0.5. Then, we want to get a quarter-note cycle, so half of 0.5 is 0.25. For an eighth note, we half the value again, giving us 0.125. And finally, for a 16th note, we use half of 0.125, which is 0.0625. Everything should work, but we need a way to choose the note duration we want to sync the LFO to. For that, we'll use a list entry module from the controls category. Hook up the choice plug from the list entry module to the choice plug on the switch. Finally, go to the LFO container and select the tempo sync module. In the properties window, check the box next to controls on module. That will show the choice box on the tempo sync module. Now we can choose what duration we want to sync the LFO's cycle to. We can test out each option. Here's a whole note. Half note. Quarter note. Eighth note. And 16th note. I'll set the synth's polyphony to 1, and the tempo sync to 8th notes. By syncing the LFO to the tempo, the modulation will fit with the track you're playing on better, syncing up with the pulses of the beat. This would be even better if we could choose whether we want to sync it to the tempo or to choose your own rate with a slider. We'll talk about how to route signals like this in a future video, but you've already seen the basic principle behind it in this example. Thanks for watching.